All right. At least we learned something valuable today.
This way!
Until now to finally figure that out. You know, canceling out of the memory box in the codec screen. Because up until today, I was under the belief that you couldn't do it unless if you called somebody, you know, and then it allowed you to cancel it then, you know, because it would close the box for you. You know, because in other games, you could close out of it with just either pressing the same button that it took to open it, or you could just cancel out of it with like circle or something, or X, whatever. You know, so it really kind of caught me by surprise, like I couldn't figure it out in this game just yet. Dr. Marv. Okay, that was my bad. I Papega aimed there. Thank you. only thing that sucks about having to reset a run is doing this part all over again. I know, it's exciting having to stand around and wait for this guy to move around. But when I'm trying to hunt for sub 56, and I'm losing time to a mechanic that really shouldn't be an issue, but it was, you know, what I could have done was maybe tried my hand at Pigeon RNG to see if that would be enough, but then I would ask myself, well, why would I accept such a really stupid time loss so early that's not something I'm really, like, pitting myself up against, right? You know, with, not even before Running Man, or during Running Man, but, like, way before it, right? It was time loss because of a codec with Madnar, and for some reason, when I tried to close out of it, I accidentally pulled the memory box open, couldn't figure out how to close it, and I did that twice over, you know, and, you know, the run before, it was because of a swimming mistake that lost me nearly a minute, so I have to ask myself, well, yeah, maybe I could have gave Pigeon RNG a chance, which is like 20 minutes in, find out if I made the right choice or not, or I just do it over knowing that whatever time I have is what I have, and RNG will determine where it goes. Not because of, like, you know, human error. A better arrival time, at least getting here. Mm-hmm. like plus 10, you know, at this point. Man, I'll admit some of that time lapse was because of the swamps, which is sadly nothing new. Gonna answer the radio so I don't forget. Alright, don't miss it. Thank goodness. Never thought I would see it happen in a run again, but... always be wary of that turn. Ready for the elevator ride to floor 30. Just kidding, no one is ever truly ready for the ride to floor 30. Heck, I don't know if the elevator is even ready to go up to the 30th floor. Big old split right there. Okay, that's definitely gonna help. But what really matters is this pigeon RNG coming up. Alright, it's in the area, but not on the ground. Still not on the ground. Still not on the ground. Still not. Oh my god, don't do this to me. Oh my god, dude. Alright, it's flown a lap now. Okay, it's on the ground. Finally. God. You love it, you hate it, but you still hate it. just gonna say go for it. You know, it's like I said at the beginning, I roll my dice with the pigeon RNG. You know, and whatever time I have going up to it is what I have. And I know there's time save at the end of the game. You know, between, you know, Gray Fox and Big Boss, and if Jungle Evil decides to behave. So, it's not completely out of the water like it was with doing the extra lap underwater by mistake. Surplus decoys from Mother Base. Except that guy. Menu there. Armored Roombas again. There to the bridge. So what I'm hoping for is at least be near break even. You know, Pigeon RNG flew a lap. Gustava was pretty fast, you know, me meeting up with her. So I'm hoping that'll at least make up for some of what's going to be some time loss here. His snake was about to cross the bridge. It blew up! Rip Gustava. Metal. Feet? Oh, thank goodness I wasn't Metal Gear. Alright, that time loss was probably a little worse than I thought it would be, but I did get a really nasty pigeon. So the rest is gonna be up to however the end game turns out. Mm-hmm. almost caught myself doing a... doing an unnecessary departure there. I've gotten off on the wrong floor before, and this is not the time to do it. Oops. Plus decoys. Except that guy. How about in here? Okay, they were nice again. Bring on the four papagas. One, two, three. Another set of three. There we go. Saved a little bit of time there. Mm-hmm. Bloom. Oops. Alright, let's go stairs!
From Sarkozia?
I still don't know what causes it, by the way. Like, every time I get the signal to jump off, it doesn't do it. Like, it's kind of like on and off it happens. I'm just not sure why. Jungle Evil, ball's in your court. Huh? Oh! launching yet, but I'd rather use grenades. Oops. Way too far away. So, I actually saved a second. Despite him crossing over sectors. But more importantly, we got the egg. Wait, I would get rid of that. Philosopher's Legacy, I got the egg. It's the most important thing of all in the game. Objective. Gotta do your thing. Hoop, hoop. Yeah, oh, must be nighttime already. Thank you. Alright, got the key. That's one way to do it. I technically should have had the key equipped during that fight instead of the ration. Alright, that'll be something to remember next time.
Sarkozian? As in from Sarkozia?
Man, this guy is a tough one for taking four claymore mines directly. But in the meantime, whee! Hog slide! Oof! Well, it's not Metal Feet anymore. Metal Gear D, pounded by Gray Fox.
Sarkozia? As in from Sarkozia? Sarkozian? As in, from Sarkozia?
Yep, that's definitely how I remember the epic battle between Snake and Gray Fox. Just luring him onto the mines in there. Once again, Big Boss Man. Time for your antics about holding me up disguised as a guard. We got a chopper to catch. Does it, chat, because this would be like the greatest comeback in a run I've ever done. Man, I can't believe I was able to pull this back after that messenger pigeon. I'm not even kidding. Like, I was just shaving away a little bit at a time. And I got possibly the best big boss fight I could possibly get. You know, having him confined to one spot and then he went up. Didn't really leave the screen that very, you know, times to go after him. And even if this is not sub 56, this is definitely a PB. I mean, the RTA splits will at least tell me that much. Man, to think I had a pigeon that went a whole lap around, and I had this much time saved still. But man, that big boss fight's gonna be hard to beat now. Even if I do get like a better pigeon the following run. Doing that sub-hour challenge run in Twin Snakes for Big Boss, Saving Meryl, which is just running the game on extreme with Game Over Discover turned on normally. But the challenge that I pushed myself was to get the run under an hour IGT while saving Meryl, even though it is slower, and I was able to do it, but just barely. And I almost recall it coming down to, like, the liquid fight at the end. Man, dude, I really hope this run is sub 56, but if it's not, it'll definitely be better than 56.10. What's up, Sagoi? No, man, you're just in time to find out if this is a sub 56 run or not. And I arguably had like one of the best comebacks in a run I've done recently with how this was halfway through to where it is now. You know, getting jebaited with the pigeon to somehow clawing my way back. Sub 56, I definitely anticipate this being a PB. Mm-hmm. Suspense is building. Oh my god, I did it.
Great.
55-58. Man, that was even better than I thought. I thought it might have been like a 56, like, flat. Man, the freaking big boss fight. Clutch. That's what saved this. You know, I was just, 6 seconds behind after Gray Fox? You know, even a halfway decent big boss fight would have been probably enough to at least maybe PB above 56-10. But dude, sub 56, let's go. Man, I gotta upload this run, dude. I mean, look at this, right? I started off fairly standard. This is where I was just making the all-out commitment saying, all right, he flew a lap, got the pigeon, I'm going for it. I'm just gonna put my chips on the end of the game. You know, pass this to see if I could save it. Saved a little bit on Four Horsemen. Saved it on the Hang Glider. Jungle Evil Knife, right? Pretty much canceled each other out. Save time with Mannar. Metal Gear D, pretty much consistent. Doing the optimized Gray Fox strat. And then this is really where it saved it. You know, is having Big Boss confined to that spot. Getting so many hits in a row, not having to chase him. And that's just pure luck. You know, he can just move all over the place. And I really can't credit the run, how it got saved, other than just pure luck, I guess. Right? It was bad luck that got put it to where it was, and it was good luck that brought it back. You know, it's good luck. Good luck giveth, and bad luck definitely taketh away when it comes to this run.